In 1921, Adolf Hitler became leader of the largest party, the National Socialist German Workers, or the Nazi Party. This group supported German nationalism and anti-Semitism.
As well as Hitler, this group was not satisfied with the Treaty of Versailles, terms of making Germany pay reparations. Hitler blamed the Jews and Marxists.
Since he had access to state resources, Joseph Goebbels, Minister of Propaganda in the Nazi Party, was able to use the printing press for propaganda.
Hitler was worried about conflict from inside and outside the Nazi Party. Outside the Stormtroopers, also known as SA, was created in 1921 and were a problem when Hitler came into power.
Germans wanted a strong government and order. The Nazi meetings were huge and organized.
Hitler was a compelling speaker to the public.
He gained much support from the middle class, women, and young people. He would even be deceitful.
He had support of big businesses who thought he would prevent Germany from becoming communist.
The big business provided Hitler with money to fight elections.
People feared communism, so they supported him.
They believed he would be a tough leader who would make Germany great like it once had been.
Many reminisced back to the time of the Kaiser, the World War I ruler of Germany.
People in Germany were divided, and the government appeared almost unable to fix the problems of the time. This gave Hitler a chance to gain power.
The Weimar Republic seemed to argue more than trying to fix things.
He used propaganda, legal methods, and violence.
The Weimar Republic was weak, and Hitler opposed to it, so he stepped in and took over.
He was appointed Chancellor in 1933 of Weimar Republic.
Rise of nationalism in Germany caused people to recognize Jews as outcasts.
Hitler developed his hate of Jews while living in Vienna society.
He called anyone a Jew if they had a Jewish grandparent and called them the untouchables.
He blamed Germany's defeat on the communists, the Jews, and the Weimar Republic.
He promised order and therefore won the backing of military and the wealthy.
Nuremberg laws deprived Jews of citizenship and restricted them of doing things in 1935.
The Gestapo were his secret police.
Under his rule, the Nazis controlled all areas of German life.
The Nazis had organized the police in Prussia, Germany's largest state. The police ignored the violence caused by the SA.
Propaganda of the Nazi was successful, and it put blame on the Jews and communists and made Hitler look very powerful.
Hitler used his trial to make speeches and lay out what he devised for the future. This gained him much public support.
He came to a realization that his best way to gain power was winning elections than putsches, which are violent attempts to overthrow a government.
In 1929, the Wall Street crash in America led to a depression worldwide. Unemployment in Germany rose from 2 to 6 million in 2 years. Nazis said they would solve Germany's problems.
No party was able to administrate Germany without Nazi support, so the president agreed to what Hitler had insisted.
Communists were getting stronger in the 1930s, and the only group that seemed to be able to deal with them were the brown shirts of the Nazi Party.
September 1st of 1939, German armed forces invaded Poland, and Hitler devoted his energy to carry out the war he'd allowed to dominate Germany.
Hitler and his supporters suspended civil rights, destroyed socialists and communists, and got rid of some other political parties.
Hitler was able to dominate Germany because he was convincing, very intelligent, and had much support from the people.
He was the leader of the largest party, which helped him gain publicity quite quickly.
Also, he used techniques to get what he wanted. He was deceiving and knew how to trick almost anyone.
The Nazis did everything he called for in German society.
German citizens supported Hitler because they feared communism.
These are characteristics that Hitler had that enabled him to dominate Germany.